about this next team because Utah was 3-2 last year. And they were young. They were inexperienced, and they had a lot of new faces over there. I think defensively in particular, it wasn't quite up to the program standard, or at least our expectations. But I think that, again, that's where some of the youth and inexperience come up, and we see that group take a step forward. They have a very, very interesting quarterback battle with Charlie Brewer coming in from Baylor, Jaquindon Jackson coming in from Texas, Cameron Rising and Peter Castelli are still there. I don't have a read on handicapping that one, but Brewer is somebody that we have seen be successful, and Jackson is a player who, you know, depending on, but I'll obviously love to hear from you here on Jackson, but I remember Barton being excited about Jaquindon Jackson. And so, you know, depending on his ceiling and where you see him being at, that either one of those options could make the offense a lot more interesting, especially when you look at the running back room. TJ Pledger comes in from Oklahoma. Chris Curry, who did a great job starting or playing, leading the team in rushing when Clyde Edwards-Helaire was a little bit banged up against Oklahoma in the Peach Bowl a few years ago. So Chris Curry from LSU, TJ Pledger from Oklahoma. I see of all the teams in the Pac-12 South, if there's a team that is going to be taking a step forward or building on what we saw last year, I kind of think Utah would be where I would saddle up. I would declare Utah as the biggest threat to USC winning the division. And I think a lot of it is the combination of the transfers that you've got coming in and the defense in particular taking a big step forward. I'm excited about this group.
See, I thought the defense was pretty good last year.
Thought so?
As far as like I think they weren't great in the red zone, and I think that probably inflates the stats a little bit. But if you just look at the points per drive allowed, they were actually second in the conference at only 1.81, which is right behind Arizona State at 1.79. So I think overall the defense was fine. It was also a very young defense, because I remember like the defense going into the season was a concern because they had been great in 2019 and they'd lost a bunch. I was pleasantly surprised. So maybe my expectations are clouding what I remember seeing of it. But
and they played at pace more, Tom. Last year, and their opponents, they played at pace like crazy. Like they were bottom 10 in the country in terms of drives faced. Like they had to defend a lot more drives than they normally would.
Yeah. So I think that defense is probably going to be pretty solid in 2021. I think that quarterback's better because we remember before the season started last year, my feelings about Jake Bentley, and I was never shy about that. Jake Bentley's gone, so I think that we're going to see a better situation at quarterback for the Utes this year. Charlie Brewer's coming in, isn't it, too, like from Baylor?
Yeah, he's the presumptive starter there.
Yeah, so I don't know. I think a lot of this is going to depend on the quarterback and what they can do offensively, because I do think defensively they're still going to be in. I think special teams-wise, Utah is always pretty solid on special teams, so I think they're going to be solid there. So yeah, Chip, I get where you're coming from, where this is kind of like, again, the quote unquote dark horse team in the South. I think that they could pose problems for USC and another team that I would probably consider to be more of a favorite that we haven't gotten to yet.
That's foreshadowing. I would say, first of all, I mean, we need to acknowledge, you know, Ty Jordan's untimely death due to an accidental gunshot back in his home state of Texas in the offseason. So I mean, obviously tragic for, you know, Utah and his family. As far as the transfers that they took, right? Like body type wise, Utah is going for some thick boys here. Like Chris Curry, TJ Pledger are like, you know, 5'10", 2.25 type build dudes. They clearly want to pound the rock there at Utah. And I think they should be able to do so. I saw Curry a lot. He's actually from, you know, Fort Myers area. And so got to see him a lot in person. He's a good back, and there's a reason he left LSU. I think mostly, you know, competition there. It's hard to start at LSU, but he's no doubt pretty good. I do have some questions about Charlie Brewer. I was never really in love with him in 2019, despite the fact that Baylor did go to the Big 12 title game. I don't think he's necessarily like a next level quarterback prospect, but at the same time, I don't really believe he's quite as bad as he showed last year. I think there were some things going on with that Baylor offense that really hurt everybody. I mean, it almost has to be, right? Like Larry Fedora's never had an offense anywhere close to that bad, and they made a bunch of changes, you know, in the offseason. I think receiver is an opportunity for Utah to step up quite a bit this year. And I'm focusing mainly on the offense because their defense brings back like everybody, and they're going to be really, really damn good, I think. But they get Puka Nacua and Solomon Ennis to transfer in. Both those guys are pretty proven type playmakers. Jalen Dixon decided to not transfer out despite being in the transfer portal. So that's pretty big for them. I think – oh, and what's his name? Coven. Britton Coven's still there. So I feel like they're in a much better spot receiver-wise, and that should help them get the ball down the field a little bit more, which was something they really struggled to do last year. They were actually dead last in the nation at passes to outside receivers. So
127.
Buck 27. Yeah, because remember, three teams didn't play. UConn Huskies, New York Times national champions. So, yeah. That's kind of defense. I don't have any real thoughts. They're going to be awesome, I think.
Yeah. I mean, that's where I think, you know, two things come to mind when I think of Utah. I think of an identity, you know, strong defense with, and Bud, you're talking about guys that are going through the portal. Like, that's all I always think about Utah is just thick dudes on the defensive line, outstanding defensive line play, some of the best in the Pac-12. And they're building on that. So the defense, I'm not worried about. I'm more bullish on Charlie Brewer. I like what I saw from him. You put him with a little bit better surroundings around him and ask him not to do as much and kind of, you know, manage the game with a good defense. You know, it'll be interesting to see how that quarterback battle plays out. But I feel like Utah is that team that we always kind of overlook because they don't have as much talent as the top teams in the country, and yet they pretty much consistently overperform expectations, or they're always right there in the end, kind of in the hunt. And I mean, Kyle Whittingham has done there, has been pretty phenomenal. Like, I feel like they're the Wisconsin of the Pac-12, maybe. Like, they just don't get the respect because they haven't got over the hump and made a playoff or done something spectacular. But I feel like they're a consistent winner. So I think it all depends on, you know, and it's like you say, it's about a lot of teams that we've talked about, is how does the quarterback battle play out and how much they get out of that quarterback.
That's a great analogy, Danny. I mean, right? The Wisconsin of the Pac-12, like that is kind of what, you know, what Utah is, right? Like, they maximize, they're better than all these blue blood teams that you think should be better than them. They play nasty defense. They run the football. They don't throw the football well enough to actually compete for a national title or, you know, win a game in the playoff. But, like, that's pretty good. Jaquindon Jackson, Chip, since you mentioned it, I forgot. Really, really good athlete. As a quarterback, I thought he was kind of raw as a thrower. I think one of the reasons why Barton was probably high on him is because, you know, Tom Herman, famous for the QB run game stuff, you know, Urban Meyer disciple, really, you know, did a lot of QB run game stuff when he led his team to the national title as the OC at Ohio State and ran the hell out of Sam Ellinger early on in his career. I think Utah is a better fit for him than what Steve Sarkisian is going to run at Texas. So I totally understand the transfer. I think his upside is actually pretty high if they're able to develop his arm, because athletically, I mean, the guy's a freak.
So you're getting in Brewer for now and Jackson maybe for the future.
Yeah. And by the way, I know that Pledger and Curry are not 225. Don't give us 3 or 4 star reviews for that. But they're like, if you look at them, they're both, you know, hashtag thick.